Good afternoon, everybody. We are waiting, everybody. We will wait a few minutes, maybe 2 or 3 minutes. And then we'll start. Good afternoon. I have some noise during, I will have maybe some noise during the presentation. I tried to configure my microphone, but I have some person who are working on the building, so I hope you will not hear them.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, Eric. We will wait maybe 1 minute more, and then we will start. I think the presentation will need maybe 45 minutes for all the stuff, and after we'll answer to your questions. Okay, so let's start the presentation now. I think we have most of the people. Well, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to this webinar dedicated to Dataflow Delta. So today we will talk about the new version. Mainly, we will talk about the new version Delta. And we will explain you, for those who don't know, what is the main objective of Dataflow. So just to sum up and to give you some details, Dataflow is our product to export all your data. You can create some flows of data to extract all the AT Internet data model. So I represent you the best version that we have created for the moment. It's the Delta version. And I know that lots of you were waiting this new version Delta. So we'll go in details and see how the product works, technically how it works, what are the different features available in this new version. So we can start the presentation with all this stuff. I'm Michael. For those who don't know me, I'm the product manager of Dataflow. I'm also currently working on the e-commerce part, so all the e-commerce analysis with Sales Insights and the Sales Tracker. And I also work on the data model topic. And today I'm with Eric, Eric Lopez, who is the product owner of Dataflow. He is working on all the export topic. And he has a good understanding on how Dataflow works and has been designed technically. So he will be available after the presentation to answer to your technical question if you have some of them. So don't hesitate to send us some questions during the presentation. You have a special part, question and answer question on Zoom to send us different questions. At the end of the presentation, we'll take some time to answer to all your questions. And if we don't have enough time to answer, we will come back to you after by email and answer to all your questions. So, what's the program today? We will first talk about the main objective of Dataflow. We will answer to the question, why did we have created Dataflow? For those who don't know Dataflow and maybe who don't know AT Internet and you want to discover how it works. And we'll talk about the data model, the new data model Delta, and the different features that we have changed between the previous data model and the new data model Delta. And you will see that it's much more simple to use in all the suites and especially for Dataflow. We'll see then in a few minutes which improvements we did on this new amazing Delta version. And we will go in detail in the product to see which improvements we have done on this version. Then we will talk about the schedule export and Snowflake data sharing, which are the two main features of Dataflow. And I will share to you all the product roadmap. So what we have planned for the future and the different developments that we have planned for Dataflow. And finally, we will talk about the migration from the Dataflow, the actual Dataflow, to the Dataflow Delta, the new version. So for the different organizations who are not clients from AT Internet for the moment, it will not be very interesting, this last version, this last part. But for our clients here, it's very interesting because you will see the different steps for this migration. So let's start with the first part. So what is Dataflow? Dataflow permits you to export all your raw data from AT Internet to a data lake, for example. So when I say raw data, I mean all the non-calculated data. So for example, in data query, on the suite, you have the calculated data and the non-calculated data. You have all the data available, but in Dataflow, you only have the raw data, so all the non-calculated data. So thanks to Dataflow, you will be able to create some flows of data to export all your data or your data model on a data lake, for example, and then you will be able to cross all these data with other types of data, for example, CRM, logs, call center, social media, and your data scientist will be able to analyze these data and play with them. So it's easy to understand. Dataflow permits to export all your AT Internet data to another place, a data lake, for example, to use your data and to play with them. So now let's see how we have improved the data model with this new data model Delta. So we'll start with the actual, so the Analytics Suite 2 and the data model, which is linked with the Analytics Suite 2. In the Analytics Suite 2, as you already know for our current clients, you need to create different flows of data with Dataflow. And you had to do it by your universe. You have this notion of universe. So as you can see on the right, you will have lots of files. So each file is for the different universe. And these files are sent on an SFTP or Amazon S3. And then all these files needed to be reconciliated on your side. And then you can work on your data. So we were not very happy about this system because it's not really easy to use and very user-friendly. So we took some time to work on this new data model Delta that you will see just after on the next slide. We wanted to make it simple and to give you more possibility with Dataflow. We needed this new data model Delta. So it's why we have launched the new Analytics Suite Delta with the new Dataflow, which is available from now. So how it works on the Analytics Suite Delta, if we compare with the previous version, here you don't have any notion of universe. You have a unified storage, which permits to have all the events and all the properties available on your data model. So you are able to export, if you want, all your properties and all your events in one flow. So compared to the previous version, you need to do different flows with the different universe, etc. Here you can, if you want, export all your AT Internet data model in one flow with all your properties. So it's very simple and easy. And on Dataflow Delta, if you want, obviously you can continue to create different flows. If you want to keep 4, 5, 10, 20 flows, you can do it. But obviously, it's better if you can maybe create one flow with all your data, and then you can work on it on your side. You will understand why I'm saying that after, when you will see the different options available. It's a dynamic flow, so it's very easy to manage. So I talked about the data models, the difference between the actual data model and the new one with Delta, and what are the benefits on data flow. So now let's see what have been changed and what are the improvements that you can have on data flow Delta. On Dataflow Delta, you have three main products, and we'll see after with the Delta what you have new, which feature you have, which feature is very powerful. The first one is a historic one. It's the schedule exports. So you are able here to export your data on an SFTP or cloud destination. So Amazon S3, Google Cloud Platform, Microsoft Azure. Google Cloud Platform and Microsoft Azure will come soon. We'll work on it in few weeks. You can do these exports, thanks to the scheduled exports, every 15, 30, or 60 minutes. So if we compare with the previous version, we didn't have 15 minutes periodicity, for example. But you have lots of improvements that we will see after in details. So here, just to sum up, to show you the three main features on Delta. The second one, so here we come in the Snowflake ecosystem with the second and the third one. The second one is a SQL and data sharing offer. So with the SQL and data sharing, you can access to your data directly thanks to SQL queries. So you go on Snowflake, you can launch some SQL queries, and you can directly have an access to your AT Internet table. The advantage of this access is that you have only 1 to 2 minutes freshness of your data compared to the scheduled export. You have 15 minutes regarding the freshness of data. So here you are near the real-time access. So it's very interesting for companies who want to be very reactive. And the last one, so we are still in the Snowflake ecosystem. We are talking about the third-party connectors. So what are the third-party connectors? They are connectors which are available thanks to Snowflake, which permit to send and to permit to have an access to your AT Internet data on different kind of software. For example, you have Tableau software. You can use the Tableau software connector, which is available on Snowflake. And then in a few clicks, you will have access to all your AT Internet data model on Tableau software. It's just 1 minute, you have all the access. So it's very easy to use. You don't need to have technical knowledge, for example, SQL or something like that. You just need to click on free button and then you have all the access to the data. So it's very easy. Let's see now the different improvements that we have if we compare the previous version of Dataflow and the Delta new one. I tried to just sum up with the main points, but you have other points, obviously. But here it's the main points that you have. So thanks to the new Dataflow Delta, you'll find new features on schedule export first. As mentioned before, you are able to configure one unique flow if you want to export all your data model. You can continue to have different flows, but it's possible if you want to have only one. And it's very easy and powerful, and you have different periodicity available, and you have the new one, 15 minutes, available on the schedule export. Regarding the destination of export on Delta, you are able to export on the cloud, so on Amazon S3, and soon you will be able to export on Google Cloud Platform and Microsoft Azure. You also have new formats, so you can export on CSV and JSON. So the export formats were available on the previous version, but we have added the Parquet format, which is new on this Delta version. And on Delta, you have full access to the Delta historical data compared to the previous version, which has been which was limited regarding this historical data. Here you have a full access on your Delta historical data. Finally, we worked on a solution for you to check if the exports were well generated. And we have created a new file. We call it a report file, which permits to give you all the information about what which files we have generated and which file have been sent to you. So you just need to check the list inside the dot report file, which permit to check if you have received all the files that we have generated. It's a security that we have added on this Delta version that was not available in the previous version. And then we did a big step forward with this new Delta version and regarding Snowflake data sharing. So it's a new offer that we have added in Delta. You have real-time access to the data, like I said before, around 1 to 2 minutes compared to the scheduled exports. It's much more powerful. You can use the SQL or the connectors to access to the data, which were not available. Finally, you have a fair use of resources. What I'm meaning about fair use, because when you launch a SQL query on Snowflake, you will only use the warehouse, the best warehouse to launch your SQL query. So you will not use a big warehouse, XAL warehouse, for example, to launch a simple query. It will be the smallest warehouse. So you just use the resource that you need to launch your query. So it permits to reduce the ecological impact. You have a direct access to the event database, like I explained before, thanks to the data sharing and Snowflake. And you have a big ecosystem of connectors, which is available. You have more than 70 different third-party tools connectors, which are available. So let's go now into Dataflow Delta to show you exactly how it works and all the possibilities. So now we will go on the product to show you how it works. First, we'll talk about the scheduled exports. So the different flows that you can create to export your data on the different destinations with different configurations. So we'll first talk about the scheduled exports. So how scheduled exports work? It's easy and fast to set up. In fact, first you select the sites where you want to export the data. Then you select the different properties, the properties that you want to add on your flow. And finally, Dataflow will generate the files in the format that you have chosen, CSV, JSON, or the new format Parquet. You can choose a periodicity, 15, 30, 60 minutes. In the interface, you have all the things to set up your flows, then the flows are generated. So it's very easy to do it. I have added some screenshots of the interface just to show you how it is in real life. You have on the first screen, you can select the scope of your exports. So you can select the whole organization, or you can select one or several sites. Then you can choose if you want to use a privacy feature. So it's a very important feature, a new feature available in this Delta version. You can, if you want, exclude all the non-consent data in one click. So with this option, you just can exclude all the non-consent data. If you want to keep all your events or your data, you can choose the second option, all events. We will add automatically on your export a new column called privacy. And then you can, after generation of data, that you have received your files, you can filter the data on your side. So just one column to give you the information about the privacy mode. And then the last step of this first screen, you can choose the data that you want to export. So it's the most important. You can first choose all data. So it will include all the existing and future property. So what I mean with existing and future property, I mean, if you add a new property, for example, today you create a flow, you do all the configuration, etc. You select this option, all data, and you generate your flow. Tomorrow you will add one new property or several different new properties, and you will automatically have on your flow these new properties that you have added. And you just need to do nothing. You just need to receive the data because it's automatic, it's dynamic. But if you choose a second option, custom data, you will need to choose and to tick the different properties that you want to add on your exports. And so it's not dynamic here because you just need to choose the property that you want. And if you add another property tomorrow, it will not be added to the flow if you choose custom data. So it's very important to think about exporting maybe all your IT internet data model, like I said before. It's why I said you will understand after, because if you choose this option, you just need to do one flow, you export all your IT internet data model, and you know that you will be up to date always. So it's very interesting. This option is very interesting. Lots of our clients are using this option because it's more easy to use every day. Yes, if you choose the custom data, so you go on the next screenshot, you will have this interface. Then you will be able to tick the different properties that you want to add on your flow of data. You have some different filters available at the left of your screen. These filters permits you to search the different properties that you want to add easily. If you want to go on audio and video, you will have all the AV properties available, etc., etc. So it's more easy to set up. If you want to select all the properties from one category, it's possible. And then one more information, some properties are mandatory, so you can't untick them. You need to choose them and they are automatically added. You have the list here. I think they are all here, but it's for our technical team, it's mandatory for us to have these properties, so we have added them. Then we go on the second screen and the last one. So we took a lot of time to explain the different screen, but in fact it's just two screens and it's very easy to and fast to set up. So here you can choose the name of your flow. You can choose the format that you want for your files. So you have CSV, JSON, Parquet, and you have all the configuration linked to the different formats. For example, for CSV you have the field separator, field encapsulation, etc., etc. So you can choose all these configurations. You need to know that all the files are compressed in gzip format. You have the information here. So you will choose the format that you want and then it will be compressed in gzip format. And then you will choose the frequency of your export. You have 15, 30 or 60 minutes. And we have added a new feature which was not available in the previous version. So it's partitioning. What is partitioning? It's a kind of folders that we create, and we will put all your data, all your files inside. So for example, here we have a partitioning with date hour. We will create one folder with a date, inside one folder with the hours, and then we'll put the file inside. So it's easy to manage your files thanks to this partitioning feature. Then you will choose the destination where you want to send your data. So Amazon S3, FTP, and soon you will have Google Cloud Platform and Microsoft Azure. And here you have exactly the same interface than on the previous version. For those who already know the previous version, you can create a new configuration here if you don't have one already available on the connection. So in two screens, if I have to sum up, you can configure easily your flows and generate them directly after when you save your flow. So we talked about the schedule exports, and now we'll go on Snowflake, the Snowflake part with SQL and data sharing option. So if you're interested in using the data sharing, so with SQL or even the different connectors that we'll talk about after, you can have a direct access to the data model thanks to the data sharing. And if you already have a Snowflake account, it's the case number one here, we will give you the access to your 8 internet data model directly on your existing Snowflake account. So there is absolutely no technical problem to share all your 8 internet data model to your existing Snowflake account. The second case, if you don't have Snowflake on your company, you didn't work with Snowflake at all, you don't have any Snowflake accounts, 8 internet is able to give you a Snowflake account only for you, and you will be able to have the access exactly like the previous case. You will be able to have the access to your 8 internet data model directly on your new Snowflake account that we have created. So you will have the access to all your data of 80 internet. Just one information, one precision. All our clients so can use the data sharing, and I always have the question that if you need to do a contract with Snowflake or something like that, you don't need to deal with Snowflake. We are working with Snowflake, so all our Delta version is based on Snowflake. So if you want to test or to use the SQL and data sharing option, you just need to deal with us, and then we will activate your Snowflake account or the access to your data, and we do everything technically to give you the access. I have put a screenshot of the interface of Snowflake just to show you how it works. So it's very easy. On the left, you have the 8 internet table that we have shared with your Snowflake account or the Snowflake account that we have created for you. At the top of your screen, you have the area where you put your SQL queries. So here we have launched just the first SQL query in gray here. And here at the bottom, you have all the results of your query. Here you have some null data. It's normal because it's a demo account, so we didn't put all the data inside, but don't worry, you will have all your data inside when you will launch all your queries. So it's very easy to use. You have three main areas, and here you can see the time that the query has spent to be finished. So it's 8 seconds, and 100 rows has been sent to the results. One second important interface in Snowflake, you have an interface which permits to track the credits which has been used on your Snowflake account. So when you use Snowflake, for those who don't know, you always consume Snowflake credits. These Snowflake credits, if you already have a Snowflake account, you will use your Snowflake account. So you will use your Snowflake credits. So you don't need to pay something. You will pay your Snowflake credits. And if you don't have any Snowflake account and 8 internet will create one for you, we will bill all the Snowflake credits that you have used monthly. Why we do that? Because when you use the Snowflake account, when you launch some query, Snowflake will bill us, will bill 8 internet the different Snowflake credits that you have used, and then 8 internet will bill the Snowflake credits to you. So it's normal. It's like if you have If you already have a Snowflake account with your credits and you use them. So it's normal to work like this. So here you can use the interface to track how many credits you used, just to plan for the next month. For example, if you are doing exactly the same SQL query each month, you can test it during 1 month, and after 1 month you will know how many credits and how much it will cost you to launch these queries each month. So it's very easy to use, and it's simple. I just show you the two main interfaces, but you have different settings available, for example, for the size of the warehouses, etc. So if you need more information, more precise information about Snowflake, don't hesitate to ask the CSM or even Eric and I, and we will be able to answer to all your questions. A small video now just to show you in live how it works. So it's exactly what I explained before, just 1 minute maximum. So you log in on the Snowflake account, so your Snowflake account or the Snowflake account that we have created for you. You go on the interface, you have the 80 internet table events available at the left of your screen. Then you launch the first query. So here it's a simple query with just event time. We filter on the event time. The query is launched, and it took 4 seconds to be finished with more than 400,000 rows. And you have all the data available here. You have the different columns, and you can filter the different columns available. If you want to remove them or add some of them, you can manage them here. So I go fast on this point because I just explained it before. It's just to show you in live how it works. So I go on the next slide. And the last one regarding Snowflake and the data sharing, you have the connectors part. So like I explained before, these connectors permit to use and exploit all your data, 80 internet data on different softwares, for example, Tableau, Power BI, etc. So we'll see it in details. You can see here some connectors which are already available on Snowflake with the data sharing. As you can see, all the data model from 80 Internet is available on the different platforms on the right of your screen. So it's just examples, but you have much more. If you go on the Snowflake website, you will have all the connectors available. You have lots of them. So I'm pretty sure that lots of you have different software that you are using. So you will see how easy it is to use this connector. So I'm pretty sure that you will be interested in using these connectors. All the connectors works approximately on the same way. So if you want to have more information about one type of connectors, for example, just for Click or just for Tableau, just for Sigma, etc., you can go on the website of Snowflake and you will have the exact information about how it works, etc. So I have created one example with Tableau because lots of our clients are using Tableau and Power BI for data visualization. It's very easy. So I have created one example. So here, first step, so we share the 80 internet data model on your Snowflake account. So it's the first step, and then we just do it one time, and after you will have the access to, all the time to your 8 internet data model. So here you have the table events. Then you go on Tableau software and you click on the Snowflake connector. You just need to fill in the URL of your server, the server of the Snowflake account that you have. You fill in the username, the password, and you sign in, and that's it. After you have all your data model available on Tableau software, here you can see that you have the events event table, and with one drag and drop, you can have all your data available, and after you can work on your different dashboards to improve them and to have dynamic dashboards. again, a short video to show you in live how it works. So it's very fast. So the video is 20 seconds. There is a problem, I think. Yeah, there is a big problem. PowerPoint is closing, I think. Wait seconds. Okay, I have a bug with PowerPoint. I need to start it again. I'm sorry about this technical problem. Share my screen again. I just wait. We were talking about connectors. Try to share my screen again. Okay, I hope it will not bug again. He doesn't want to launch the video. Okay, I showed you before how it works, so I think it's clear. If you have some questions or you need a live demo, don't hesitate to ask me. I'm sorry about this problem, but I can't show you the video, so I will go on the next slide. So if you want to test the SQL and data sharing, or even the connector parts, you can test this SQL and data sharing offer. So we offer you a test account, which is available during 1 month, 30 days to be exact. And we offer $400, which will be automatically available on your test account. $400, it's around 100 Snowflake credits. So it's a lot of Snowflake credits. And it will permit you to launch lots of SQL queries, to use different connectors. We have lots of clients who has tested this offer, and they always stop before these $400 because they already have tested the solution. So if you already are a client from AT Internet, you will be able to test this data sharing with all your data. So it's very interesting, because you can use the data sharing exactly like when you will maybe be clients of this offer. So you will be able to play with your data, to see how it works, to see the different functionalities that you can use, etc., etc. And then you have the real-time interface, like I said before, I presented to you the real-time interface, which permit to see how many credits you used, and so how much you will be billed at the end of the month. So regarding the pricing, so I sum up all the pricing in one slide. So if you have questions, don't hesitate to ask. I think it's quite clear, but if it's not, don't hesitate to ask some question on the chat. So if you want to use the schedule export or data sharing or the connectors, etc., the first step is to activate the option data flow. When you activate the data flow option, you will have the access to the schedule export and data sharing and the connectors. So first you activate the data flow option, then you will have the access to the schedule exports. It's included. There is no costs regarding this use. So you will be able to create all the flows, the export flows of data, with the interface and different options, different partitioning, etc., like I presented to you at the beginning of the presentation. And then if you already have a Snowflake account and you want to use a data sharing offer, so we are here in the second column, you already have a Snowflake account. So we will, for free, we will share the AT Internet data model to you. So you will, after that, you will use your existing Snowflake account. So you will consume all your Snowflake credits, which are available on your existing Snowflake account. So we just don't deal with it. You work on your side, and we just for free share the data with you. And the last column, say if you don't have any Snowflake account, we will provide you one Snowflake account. And then, like I explained to you before, we will bill monthly the different Snowflake credits that you used during each month. So just to let you know, one Snowflake credit is $3.7, so it's 3.2 euros on average. And I always have the question if one SQL query is equal to one Snowflake credit. So it's not at all the case. One SQL query is not $3.7 because it could be very, very expensive. It's not the case. How we calculate the Snowflake credits, it's very simple. So Snowflake calculates the Snowflake credits like that. First, it's a size of the warehouse which is used for your SQL queries. If you are launching a complex Snowflake credit, Snowflake SQL query, sorry, you will use a bigger warehouse than if you launch a simple query on Snowflake. So the size of the warehouse is important when the Snowflake credits are calculated. And then the request time. More the request is complex, sorry, more the price will be important. So it's normal because the request time will be bigger. And then you have the Snowflake credits that you have to pay. So just to let you know, for all our clients, if you launch SQL classic SQL queries, if I can say this like this, you will always have 0.0 something Snowflake credits. So it's not at all expensive. Obviously, if you want to export all your data model, all your 8 internet data model to your to another place, if you take all the data with absolutely no filter, etc., it will cost a lot because you take all your data models. So it's normal you take all the data. And the last information regarding the pricing, and after you will have all the information, there is a minimum of 30 credits monthly billed. So it's on average $100, sorry, per month. Then if we talk about the product roadmap, just to share with you the different updates that we want to share with you and to add on your data flow on the new version. Have a look on the hour. It's okay. We have we will have 10 minutes to answer to the questions. So regarding the roadmap, here is the roadmap of data flow delta only from Q3 2021 to Q2 2022. I prefer to specify here that it's a projection of the roadmap, so it's not fixed at all. It can move, so we can change this roadmap. It's just to give you an idea of what we have planned to do during next months. So first, in the third quarter, we worked a lot on the last feature of data flow delta, so mainly on partitioning, as mentioned before, and the privacy filter to exclude all the non-consent data. And we provide you nearly access to the Delta version. The early access had all the features of the definitive version. So you had the possibility to use the partitioning, privacy filters, all the settings when you wanted to create some flows. So it's exactly the same thing. The only thing not available in this single earlier access is history regeneration. So if there is a need to regenerate data, we are not able to do it. So in the version one, in the definitive version, like you can see at the bottom left of your screen, you will be able with this last version, the definitive version, will be able to have all the features available. So just to be 100% transparent on the development of data flow delta and the definitive version, we are working on the last story of the development. So we are finishing this last story. So it this last version Delta will be available very, very soon. In the fourth quarter, we worked on two different studies. We want to work on different studies, sorry. First of all, a study on the development and availability of a new export destination. So we are talking here about Google Cloud Platform and Microsoft Azure. So it's technical study to help us to manage well the development of this new destination. It's not very easy to develop the way to export on Google Cloud Platform and Microsoft Azure. So we needed to schedule some technical studies to be sure at 100% that it could be the best solution to do during the development. So in the first quarter of 2022 and after these two studies, we plan to make the Google Cloud Platform available on the export destination for the scheduled export. And also we want to give you the possibility to export every 5 minutes in the scheduled export. So like you have seen before, you have 15, 30, 60 minutes and you want to maybe add these 5 minutes available. We are going to launch a study first and then a potential development to implement this 5 minute periodicity. Why I said eventually we will do this development, because we had some clients who are interesting in having this 5 minute periodicity, but they were not very sure. So first we do a study to be sure 100% that it's technically possible. And then we will say if yes, we will add this 5 minutes or not. Regarding Q2, we want to make Microsoft Azure available like Google Cloud Platform, but in Q2 just after. And we will work on a client interface to activate autonomously the data sharing. So what is this new interface? For the moment, if you're interested in activating the data sharing, you need to contact an AT internet CSM or someone from the team. And after manually, we will add, we'll activate, sorry, this data sharing option. So it's manually, and we want to do it automatically in order to be autonomous in the in this management of the activation of the option. So tomorrow you will be able to go on the interface on the analytics with Delta and just click on activate the data sharing, and then you will have 3 steps to activate the data sharing, and in 1 minute you will be able to do this activation. And today it's more than it's more 1 hour to activate this this data sharing option. So regarding the migration, I tried to do it fast because maybe it's not for everybody here. If you're not already a client from IT Internet, it will not be very, very interesting for you. So I will go fast on this subject. If you want to migrate on Data for Delta and you are on the previous version, it's very easy. So today you are in the CDF version, so the previous version, and we can provide you some example of files which have been generated by Dataflow Delta, so the new version. And it permits you to see the structure of the files, how Dataflow Delta works, etc., etc. So you have time to see how it works, to discuss with our technical team. We are doing a lot of calls with our clients to explain how it works. Maybe the best way for you to manage the future flows of data, etc., etc. So we are available to help you and to provide you all the information needed. Then the second step, we will launch the Delta version on your account. So you will have on the same time the CDF, so the previous version, and Delta, Data for Delta, which will work exactly on the same time. So we'll have different flows on Delta and on the CDF. So this period is a 3 months period, so it's a limited time. And after this period, you will be able to cut the CDF version, so the previous version, and you will keep only the new version, the Delta. So if you need more more time than 3 months. Maybe you will say, oh, 3 months, it's very short, to a short period to do this migration. We can provide this longer period, but you will have extra costs for this, because to be transparent, when we launch the Delta version, we will have the two engine on the same time, which will work. So we have double costs. So we offer the 3 months period for this migration, but after the cost will be very important for us. So we need to stop rapidly the CDF version. It's possible, but we can talk about it if you have this case. I go fast on this last part, just to let you know that you have lots of information on the Help Center. So you have a migration guide, which permits to share with you the different steps that you have to do for the migration. Here we are talking about only data flow. So we have here the different steps for data flow. In fact, you have only one thing to do, is just recreate the different flows on Delta, because you can't do a migration, automatic migration from the previous version to the new one. You need to recreate the flows. But it's a good time if you want to rethink. Maybe previously you had 20 flows due to the universe, the technical limitation with universe. Here you have no limitation and you can just create one dynamic flow if you want. So it's a good moment to rethink how many flows you want to create, et cetera, et cetera. And the only thing you have to do after the data sharing, et cetera, are the or new offers. So you just activate them if you want to use it. And finally, you have, like I said, the migration guide on the App Center. You have the news, the product news, which are available thanks to the bell at the top right of your screen, and on the analytics suite, obviously. And we are here, all the team from AT Internet are here to answer to all your questions and to give you help if needed, if you need some advices. I have finished to share all my information that I wanted to share with you. I talked a lot, so I think we will have time to answer to the questions.
A few questions here. Okay. Well, one is for you. Will you share this presentation with all the participants?
No, I want to keep the presentation only for me. So
yeah, I understand.
No. Obviously, I will share the presentation with you. Yeah, I will send it.
Okay. Another question about GZIP compression. Will we be able to generate CSV files without GZIP compression? And the answer is no, because we have to reduce the bandwidth that is used to transfer and the files. If we don't compress the files, there we will have to send very, very large files. So we won't be able to provide you really quickly these data files. So as of now, it's not an option to not to compress GZIP files, CSV files, sorry. One possibility would be for you to use Parquet format, which is already compressed, so we don't have to convert it another time in GZIP. So maybe it would be more convenient for you. Another question was, can we just do a daily extract for our clients who are not interested in receiving real-time data? As of now, it's not possible, but we already received this demand a few times. Mm-hmm. So I think this is something that we will study next year. So we'll get back to you when we when we have more information about that. Two questions about data sharing. Using SQL on Snowflake runs on credits. Does this mean if I connect data flow via Snowflake to Tableau or R plus deployer, do I use credits as well and eventually get billed? The answer is yes. If you use AT Internet's Snowflake account, you won't use you will use your own credits if you have a Snowflake on your side. But yes, you will get billed if you use the connectors. What you can do, maybe correct me, Mikael, if I'm wrong, but I think there is a space in Snowflake where you can see what you already used in terms of credits.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I presented a few slides before. You have an interface where you can track how many Snowflake credits that you have used. And like Eric said, when you use the SQL queries or you use the connectors, it's exactly the same thing. You use always Snowflake credits. So it's exactly the same thing and you can track them on the interface.
Okay, another question about data sharing was, before you run the SQL, do you see the credit costs? If you mean, do we have a projection on how much credits a SQL query will cost? The answer is no. We can't know, and Snowflake can't know before running the SQL query how many credits will be used.
Just to add something about this answer, you have the test account which is available, and it could be an interesting solution for your question, because if you don't know how many credits it will cost, if you always have the same SQL queries that are used, or you want just to test one or two queries to see how many Snowflake credits will be used, you can use this test account to see how much it will be.
Okay, another question about tags. Selecting properties tagged with custom tags in the NDF data flow definition is or was not possible. When will that be possible? I think the problem has been fixed. We will have to check that on our side, but I think the ticket is closed. So this shall be okay now. You shall see the different custom tags appearing at the end of the first configuration page of Dataflow Delta. If it's not the case, you can also see these properties when you go on the all properties checkbox, and then you will see all the properties that you have in your data model.
You mean if you don't use the filter on the left side and you just go on all properties and at the bottom, you have...
No, if you use the filter, all properties. You okay. See, that there are two options. The option I want to have all the existing and future properties of my data model. And the second one is customize the properties you want to mm-hmm. include. Then you stay on this customize your properties, and you have a first tag, let's call it tag, all properties, and then you will see there all the properties that are in your data model that you can pick one by one if you want. So even if the custom tags don't appear, you will see these properties appear in this part. But we will check on our side for the custom tags, and I think this has been fixed maybe two weeks ago, something like that. Another question, when will the old CDF data flow be not supported or generated at all anymore? Is the date September 2022 still correct? Mikael, can you answer this one?
I'm not sure about the answer, so I need to check it again, and I will come back to you, Olivier. I need to check the information before sharing it to you.
Okay. And then we have a question that is not data flow related. How do we enable automatic merging between dashboards from CDF to NDF Delta? As when I am on EDF first, I can't open the old dashboard on CDF, and I want to have all the dashboards available to open at one place. I think you shall contact the support team on this topic.
Melanie is the product manager of dashboard. Sorry, so the support team will be able to answer, and if they are not, we will talk about this problem with Melanie, and we will get back to you.
Okay, and I think we answered all the questions.
Yeah, I think also. So thank you very much. I have seen that the sound was pixeled at the beginning of the presentation. I thought
I didn't say anything because in my ears the sound was quite good.
Okay.
So
I hope it was okay.
Yeah.
So thank you very much for your attention, and I will send you the presentation just after, and have a nice day.
Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you.